Hey guys, Paolo from GongaChops.com here. I hope you're all having an incredible week, and I want to welcome you back to our Quick Tip Lesson Series, where we're releasing new tutorials and working on some different fills, phrases, and concepts that you can incorporate into your conga playing. Now, remember that these lessons are geared towards players with a bit of experience. So if you're completely new to the instrument, please take a second to swing by GongaChops.com and check out our Congas 101 and Conga Fundamentals courses before you jump in. And if you haven't already, help us out by giving this video a like, subscribing to our channel, and turning on your notifications so you'll know when our next lesson drops. In today's lesson, we're going to expand on what we worked on last week and learn a couple more fills using our baqueteo pattern to anticipate them and create some space. So if you haven't already, make sure you check out last week's lesson to get caught up. Now, for today's fills, we're going to use a bit of a variation on the common baqueteo pattern and play close slaps on beat 2, the end of 3, and the end of 4. This pattern has a bit more movement than our common baqueteo, where we only played close slaps on beats 2 and 4. This one stems from the songo, and it's commonly used in a more modern timba or salsa context. Now, of course, you can also work on playing both baqueteos over a 2-bar phrase and choose whichever one you'd like to play in the bar before your fills. So, let's work on our first fill. We'll practice it over a 4-bar phrase in 2-3 clave. We'll play 2 bars of tumbao, followed by our baqueteo in bar 3, and our fill in the 4th bar. Now this fill works just fine even without anticipating it with our baqueteo in the bar before. But by omitting open tones for an entire bar and leaving some space in the groove, our fill will have even more of an impact. Just remember that because these types of fills are pretty busy, they're better suited to be used in the up sections of an arrangement, and generally only once in an entire song. And remember that it's super important that we take the time to analyze and clap the clave along to each example so we can start to understand how the tumbao and the accents of each fill fit and work in respect to the pulse and the clave. So, for the second fill, let's revoice the baqueteo pattern that we're playing in the 3rd bar. This time, we'll play a low drum muffled tone on the end of 3 and an open tone on the end of 4 to set up our new fill in the 4th bar. Let's check it out. Now this is one of my personal favorite ways to set up a fill, and we can think of it in a couple different ways. We can assume that the 3rd bar is still just being used to set up the following bar, since we are mainly playing non-open tones for an entire bar, a close slap on beat 2, a low drum muffled tone on the end of 3, and only playing an open tone on the very last 8th note of the bar. Or we can think of the low drum muffled tone on the end of 3 as our jumping off point for the fill. Now the difference is simply conceptual, and it doesn't necessarily change what we're playing, but thinking of the jumping off point for a fill in different places within a phrase can inspire us to play some different and at times longer shapes and help us create some tension within our fills. So for our last fill, let's use our most recent baqueteo variation in the 3rd bar. But this time, we'll leave an 8th note rest and then play a left-hand ghost tone on the last 8th note of the bar. We'll then play a ghost on the first 8th note of the following bar and play an 8th note buildup to help us emphasize the downbeat of the following phrase. Let's check it out. Now this is just a simple variation on one of the fills that we checked out a few weeks back using open tones. But placing a bar of space before definitely gives it a bit of a different feel than when we were just inserting it into our tumbao pattern. Now make sure that you take the time to go over each pattern slowly, work on the sticking and the tones, and do your best to lock up with the metronome before you speed these up. So for this last example, we'll play 6 bars of tumbao, followed by our baqueteo pattern in the 7th bar, and then each of our respective fills in bar 8. Let's see what it sounds like at a bit faster tempo over one of our exclusive Conga Chops practice loops.
1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now, generally speaking, aside from being aware of what's going on musically with the other instruments and the vocals while we're playing, this simple concept offers us one of the best ways to deliberately create some sonic and mental space to allow ourselves to become inspired to play some fills and variations like the ones we just learned. So feel free to practice doing the same thing on the opposite side of the clave as well, or by making your bacchetteo pattern longer or shorter to give your fill a different jumping off point. These types of fills are again something that you'll hear used more deliberately in a modern context. So try to see if you can spot where they come up as you're listening along to your favorite recordings. Now, analyzing and learning to understand the way that your favorite percussionists think and utilize different concepts will definitely give you a ton of insight as to when these types of fills can feel natural to play throughout the course of an arrangement, as well as generally improve the way you approach any and every musical situation, whether it's laying down a groove, playing through an arrangement, or taking a solo. Now, if you're interested in learning more about what we do on Conga Chops and how we can give you the concepts, exercises, and techniques to help you keep getting better as a percussionist, come check us out at congachops.com. We've got an incredible library of step-by-step courses and lessons, over 10 hours of exclusive practice loops, hand-picked Spotify playlists for each pertinent course and lesson on the site, and an amazing community forum where you can meet and discuss with other members as well as get one-on-one feedback on everything you're working on. Just click the link below to grab your free 7-day trial and see what it's all about. Now, please don't forget to show your support for our channel by giving this video a like, leaving a comment down below as to what you'd like to see me cover next, and hitting subscribe so you can catch our new videos. I'll see you in the next lesson.